What's up guys, RevanX here. In this video, we are gonna take a look at Rosario. This video will cover all the information that you need to know about her ascension materials, talents, builds, and lastly, what weapon is best for her. First, let's begin with her ascension materials and her level up talent. A quick note here before we begin, if you already know this stuff that I'm gonna talk about, or you just aren't interested, I suggest to skip to the next part using the timestamps that I will provide in the video. Since Rosaria is a 4-star character, she won't require you to farm the new Geovisha boss. Here are all the materials that you need to farm in order to ascend her to level 9. Now that we are done with this section, let's move on to her artifacts and builds. But first, let's take a quick look at her skills in order to understand which builds and weapon are most viable for her. Her charge attack damage has the highest scaling in the game at the moment for all the polearm users. Her elemental skill is called Ravaging Confession. Rosaria will teleport behind her opponent dealing cryo damage. However, this ability will not work on enemies like Ruin Guards. The cooldown on her E is pretty short, being 6 seconds. Keep in mind that only the final blow of her E will deal cryo damage. The initial ones are all physical damage. Her elemental burst is called Rites of Termination. Rosaria will slash all her enemies around her, then she will summon an ice lance that strikes the ground. Both actions will deal cryo damage. While the lance is active on the ground, all the enemies inside her ult will receive cryo damage for 8 seconds. Her ult is like Chongyun's E, but the area is much larger. Her Q has a 50 seconds cooldown with a 60 energy cost. Her passive talent, Regina Probationum, will increase her crit rate by 12% for 5 seconds when she hits an enemy from behind. This passive doesn't have a cooldown, so after the first 5 seconds have passed, you can do it again to refresh the buff. If you play smart, you can probably have 100% uptime on this buff. The next talent is Shadow Samaritan. After Rosaria uses her ult, all your party members except her will receive a 50% crit rate for 10 seconds, based on Rosaria's total crit rate that she has at the moment. This talent enables her to be played as a sub DPS or even as a support if you want to go that route. What you can do to benefit for both talents is to hit an enemy from behind to gain the 12% crit rate from Regina Probationum. And then you use her ult to buff the other party members. Finally, you switch to another DPS to gain the crit rate that she provided. Now, let's talk about her constellations. I'll brush over them really quickly. First constellation will increase her normal attack and attack speed by 10% for 4 seconds after she deals a critical hit. Her second constellation will increase the duration of her ult by 4 seconds. For 8 seconds that you normally have, now you will have 12 seconds with her second constellation. Her third and fifth constellations will increase the talent level by both her E and Q by 3 levels. The fourth constellation will regenerate 5 energy for Rosaria each time she deals a critical hit with her elemental skill. Her sixth constellation will decrease the opponent's physical resistance by 20% for 10 seconds after she uses her ult. All her constellations are really good, especially the first, the second and the sixth one. Now let's take a look at some builds that will be viable for her. If you go for her C6, which enables her more towards a physical build, what I recommend is 2-piece Gladiator with 2-piece Bloodstained Chivalry. You do not really need her at C6 in order to use this build. Even if you have her at C0, this build will be good if she has a weapon tailored towards physical damage. Another good set for her will be a 4-piece Gladiator. Same as the set before, this one will be tailored towards playing her as a physical damage dealer. The only difference being that you won't get the 25% bonus physical damage from the Bloodstained Chivalry to Piset. These two are the ones that I see viable on her playing as a physical damage dealer. If you pair these two with a weapon like Crescent Pike or Dragon Spine Spear, for example, you'll be doing decent numbers. The last set that I'm gonna talk about and I see viable on her will be 2-piece Gladiator or 2-piece Bloodstained paired with 2-piece Blizzard Slayer. This set will enable her to be played as a sub DPS for your other team members. If you want to use her as a support, which I won't recommend because her kit is not built towards that role, a good option will be 4-piece Blizzard Slayer. If you use the 4-piece bonus that this set provides and you already have some decent crit rate on her, you can probably get the maximum amount of crit rate that you can give to your other party members due to the Shadow Samaritan passive talent. Now let's move to the last section of the video, which is weapons. First, let's talk about some 5-star weapons that will be good for her. There are only 2 5-star weapons that I see viable on her. The first one is the Primordial Jade Spear. The weapon has a really good base attack at level 90. Plus, the weapon will give her crit rate as a substat. The weapon effect will be really good for her because she will be stacking that weapon passive really fast due to her normal attack speed. Plus, if you have her at C1, that will increase her attack speed by 10%. You can stack that weapon passive even faster. The second 5-star weapon will be the Skyward Spine. The weapon base attack at level 90 is the same as the Jade Spear. The secondary stat that this weapon provides will be energy recharge, which is not so great on her. But if you already have a good crit rate, crit damage ratio, that won't be a problem. The weapon special ability will be really nice on her because you will gain attack speed and crit rate. The rest of the 5-star pole arms that I didn't mention will not work for her because they need specific things in order to benefit for the weapon special effect. Let's move to the 4-star weapons. In this section, surprisingly, the best weapon for her will be the Crescent Pike and the Dragon Spine Spear. Both of them being craftable weapons that everybody will have access to. These two are only good for her if you are willing to go all in building her towards the max physical damage that you can possibly get. The Crescent Pike will give you a decent base attack at level 90 with a 34.5% physical damage. Your normal and charge attacks will deal additional damage equal to 20% of your attack for 5 seconds after picking up an elemental orb or particle. Due to her E having a 6 seconds cooldown, you can almost have 100% uptime on this buff with her. Next we have the Dragon Spine Spear. This one has the lower base attack at level 90, compared to the Crescent Pike, but not by that much. But instead, it has a higher physical damage bonus, 69% to be more precise. The special ability of this weapon is kinda RNG, because you cannot control when it's gonna hit. If you are gonna use the Dragon Spine Spear with a 2-piece bonus from the Bloodstained set and with a maxed level 20 goblet, which gives you physical damage, you will have around 152% physical damage bonus on her, which is kinda crazy in my opinion. Plus, if you have her at C6, which will reduce her opponent's physical resistance by 20% for 10 seconds after you used your ult, she is gonna one-shot mobs if you crit with her. I can't wait to see clips on her one-shotting Duvali. Some other 4-star pole arms that will be viable on her will be Deathmatch, Blackleaf Pole, and maybe the Royal Spear. Rosaria is a very versatile character. She does not require any specific character to be played with her, but there are some contenders that will work very well with her. First, let's talk about the supports that will be good paired with her. Here we have Bennett, Fischl and Xingqiu. Bennett, because he's Bennett and he can do anything, he can heal you and give to all your party members a nice attack buff. Fischl, she's a good pair with Rosaria because of the super conduct elemental reaction. Plus, Fischl does not require to be on the field in order to trigger the reaction. Last, we have Zinchu. You can use him and Rosaria in a freeze comp, plus he brings a lot of utility to the team. Next, we have some DPS or sub DPS that will work very well with her. First, we have Razor, but only if you have him at C4, which will decrease the target defense by 50% for 7 seconds. Next, we have Xinyang. Her level 60 passive talent will give you a 50% bonus physical damage to a shielded character. The shield can be provided by her using her elemental skill. And lastly, we have Papa John. The shield that he will generate by holding its E will decrease the elemental and physical resistance of all the enemies that are near you. Rosaria is a pretty interesting 4-star character. In my opinion, her playstyle is kinda interesting as an assassin with a polar. She's a character that is really free to play friendly because of the two craftable weapons that everybody can have access to. Her constellation, apart from the 6th one, which is really good, are not game breaking. Of course, if you compare a Rosaria at C0 with one at C6, the one at constellation 6 will deal a lot more damage. That's obvious. Her build is kinda straightforward. There are only two builds that I see viable on her. That's all that I wanted to say about Sister Rosaria. I really want to know how you guys will build her, so please let me know in the comment section. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please drop me a like and subscribe to my channel.